Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel M2K Sai. I am Khushi and today we will be solving set 1 math standard code number 30/P/1/5/1 series JBB/5. We will be solving section B today. So question number 21 is, in the given figure 5, DE is parallel to AC and DF is parallel to AE. Prove that BF upon FE is equal to BE upon EC. So we have two triangles over here, means DF is parallel to AE, that is given to us. So we will write that in given, and DE is parallel to AC, that is also given. We will write that in given. Now whatever is to prove, we will write that in to prove. Now for proof, first of all we will see that we have this bigger triangle ABC and we have this smaller triangle ABE, and in both of these triangles AD means AB is common, means BD upon DA is common. So how we will write the proof? We will write that in triangle ABC DE is parallel to AC. Therefore, by BPT theorem, BD upon DA will be equal to BE upon EC. Now, in second, we will mention that equation 1. Now, in second triangle, triangle ABE, by BPT theorem, DF is parallel to AE, that is given to us, and BD upon DA is equal to BF upon FE. Now, by equation, this is equation 1. Now, by equation 1 and equation 2, LHS is equals to LHS, therefore RHS will also be equal to each other. So we have to write a statement that as in equation 1 and 2, LHS is equal to each other, therefore RHS equals to RHS, therefore BE upon EC is equal to BF upon FE is proved. Now question number 22 is, show that 5 plus 2 root 7 is an irrational number, where root 7 is given to be an irrational number. So we have to prove this 5 plus 2 root 7 as irrational. So we will assume this to be rational. Then this will be equal to P upon Q, where P and Q are coprime and Q is not equal to 0. Now we will transfer this plus 5 to the other side. So it will become minus 5 by Q. So it will be P minus 5 by Q upon 2Q, because 2 is multiplied over here, so it will get divided. So P minus 5Q upon 2Q is equal to root 7. Therefore P minus 5Q upon 2Q is rational because they are integers. Therefore therefore root 7 is also rational, but this contradicts the fact that root 7 is irrational. Therefore P minus 5Q upon 2Q is also irrational. Therefore, you will write, hence 5 plus 2 root 7 is also an irrational number. Hence proved, right? Now, it has an OR part, that is, check whether 12n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number. For any number to end with 0, it should have a factor 5. But when we factorize, when we do the prime factorization of 12, we get 3 into 4 raised to n. This doesn't have 5 as its factor, therefore it cannot end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Now for question number 23, it says, if A, B and C are interior angles of a triangle, means A plus B plus C will be 180 degree due to angle sum property of a triangle, then show that cos B plus C upon 2 is equal to sin A upon 2. So we can write B plus C as B. When we will transfer this A to the other side, we will get B plus C is equal to 180 minus A. So we will write it as, this is cos B plus A is equals to 180 minus A equal to B plus C. So we will put 180 minus A as B plus C. So it will become cos 180 minus A upon 2. Now we will divide 180 by 2, so we will get 90, and A will have 2 as it is, so it will become cos 90 minus A and sine A by 2. We know that sine theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta, so we can write it as sine A by 2 is equals to sine 90 by A. We get LHS is equals to RHS, hence proof. Now question number 24 we have, in figure 6, a quadrilateral ABCD is drawn. is drawn to circumscribe a circle, prove that AB plus CD is equal to BC plus AD. So what is given to us, that quadrilateral AB, that ABCD is a quadrilateral. We need to prove that AB plus CD is equal to BC plus AD. For that, we will construct the, we will mark the points of contact on the quadrilateral. So we will mark it as P, Q, R, S. Now, if you know that from point A, we have two tangents, AP equal to AQ. From point C, CS is equal to CR. From point D, we have DQ is equal to DR. From point B, BP is equal to BS. So, we will write this to form the equation. So, AP is equal to AQ. Then, BP is equal to BS. DR is equal to DQ. And RC is equal to CS. So, we will add all these equations by 1 plus 2 plus 3. So, we will get AP plus PB. We will get it as AB plus DR plus RC. DC is equal to AQ plus DQ, it is over here, we can add them. AQ plus DQ will be AD plus CS plus BS BC. So, this will form a quadrilateral like this. Now, the next part is, in figure 7, find the perimeter of triangle ABC if AP is equals to 12 cm. Now, we have to find the perimeter of this triangle ABC, and we have the value for AP. This is the value for AP. So, we know that AP will be equal to AQ because they both are tangents to the circle. And then by subtracting BP from both of them, we can find this. And then we can find the perimeter of the triangle given. Next question is question number 25. Find the mode of the following distribution. We know the formula for mode. This is L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus 2F into H. So, we will get model class over here is this, because it has the highest frequency. It will be F1. It will be F0, one before the frequency. This will be F2, and the height will be 40 minus 30, that will be 10, and lower limit will be 30. Putting all these values in the equation, we will get the final mode value. You can, for the final solution, you can see set to question number 21. It is the same as that. Next question is question number 26. For question number 26, it says that two cubes, each of volume 125 cube, are joined end to end. Find the surface area of the resulting cube. Now, this is the reverse of the... So, the two cubes are joined together. Like, if this is one cube, one another cube is joined to form two cubes. Wait, I'll show that to you. Like this. Two such cubes are joined together. Their volume is 125, and we need to find all the sides surface area. So, we need to find the surface area. Means, we do not have to find the total surface area. We just have to find the curved surface area of this. Means, we will just find the curved surface area of both the cubes, and then we will add this, these two sides, to find the total area. So, what we have? We have two cubes. Volume is, each of volume means total volume becomes, ...250 cm³. Now, if this is 125, we will do under root of 125. We will do under root of 125. Now, whatever will be the value, that will be the sides for both the cube. Now, for the surface area, what we have to do? We have to do 4a square. So, we will multiply this side by 4a square. We will do 4a square so that we get the curved surface area plus 2a square. So, means like this, we will get this side, that this curved surface area, that will be 4a square. This curved surface area, that will be 4a square. Now, a square plus a square will be 2a square, because the area of one side of a triangle, one side of a square is a square, means a square plus a square plus 2a square, means we will do it as 6a square. So, if you will do it in this manner, you will get the total surface area of the cube. So, this was all in section B. Thank you for watching my video. We will be meeting in our next video with section C.